Hi guys, welcome back to Ajit channel. So today we will have a discussion on different topic, that is anemia in livestock. So we will not be dealing with the pathology or the microbiological sections of the anemia, but we'll be dealing with anemia in a brief, so that we will be discussing the general condition of anemia in animals and general treatment protocol. So if you haven't subscribed our channel yet, feel free to subscribe and hit the bell button for more updates. So what is anemia? Anemia is an absolute decrease in RBC numbers, hemoglobin concentration or PCB. So signs will include pale mucous membrane, increased heart rate and hypotension. So diagnosis can be made by complete blood count test. So this is the classification of anemia. So you can see the etiology is acute blood loss, chronic disease, hemolysis, infection, inflammation, malignancy, renal insufficiency, sickle cell. So these are other things. You can just go on to these things. So this is blood smear. They will be looking like hypochromic microcytic. So we'll be dealing with the classification in a separate video. So anemia, that is decreased RBC production, which can be actually microcytic. That means the cells are very small. Normocytic, that is the cell size is normal, and the macrocytic, that means the cell size has increased. And in the macrocytic there are two types, that is megaloblastic and non-megaloblastic. So appropriate RBC production, in that extrinsic RBC defects and intrinsic RBC defects, that is actually whenever the RBC production is in the normal stage, but there are many problems with the normally produced RBC. So we'll be mainly focusing on the cause of anemia and the morphology of anemia. So the cause. The main cause of anemia is actually through blood loss or inadequate production of normal blood cells or excessive destruction of blood cells. So we'll be dealing with the blood loss in first case. So where all this blood loss can appear? That is actually in any surgery, that is cesarean section, rumenotomy, there will be huge blood loss. So that can result in anemia. Next is injury or accident. Injury due to any trauma or internal bleeding and accident. This can result in blood loss. Next is the parasitic infestation. So the internal and external parasites, they will be sucking blood and nutrients. So that what happens? They will be growing in a good manner, but the general condition of the animal decreases. So the roundworms, tapeworms and flukes, ticks, lice, mites and fleas. So these are the parasitic infestation. Moving to the second thing, that is inadequate production of normal blood cells. That can be mainly due to any disease condition or nutritional deficiency. In the nutritional deficiency, in the peripartum period, that is actually after parturition, they will be having higher demands, and if we are not giving much food, this can lead to decreased nutritional pay. In the pregnancy condition, they are in a high nutritional plane, and in the young ones, it is very common the nutritional deficiency. Next is actually the disease, which will result in inadequate production of normal blood cells, that is chronic and congenital disease, hereditary spherocytosis, elliptocytosis, thalassemia, sickle cell disease, etc. Next is actually excessive destruction of the blood cells, that means RBC breakage. That can be due to infections or metabolic causes. Infections, we can classify them as bacterial, protozoan and viral, in which protozoan are the main. That is, in Babesia and Theileria, it is very common. Trypanosoma, Plasmodia and Toxoplasma, it is also there. So in case of Bartonella and Salmonella, they will be having destructive phase. In case of viral, that is influenza, measles, herpes and cytomegalovirus. So moving to the metabolic causes, they are actually due to the poisons or toxins ingested, or can be due to mineral toxicity. In case of arsenic, sulfur, lead and plump compounds, it is very common. In moving to the toxins, mainly the bacterial toxins and the fungal toxins and toxins by plant and snake venom. There are hemolytic snake venoms. Next is actually the morphology. So morphology, anemia can be microcytic, normocytic and macrocytic. So in case of microcytic, the size will be decreased. That is, MCV will be less than 80. In case of macrocytic, MCV will be greater than 100. So normocytic MCV will be nearly between 80 to 100. So microcyte can be due to iron deficiency, chronic infections, thalassemia, hemoglobinopathies, sideroblastic anemia. So normocytic anemia will be happening in chronic disease, early iron deficiency, hemoglobinopathies, combined deficiencies, etc. In macrocytic, it's actually megaloblastic anemia, liver disease, etc. So the diagnosis will be clinical signs. We can diagnose by tentative, that is clinical signs, complete blood count, CBC, and blood profile. So treatment will be, first of all, if at all there is any disease, we have to treat the disease. So whenever the disease is treated, the animal will be regaining its body condition. Iron supplements by mouth, proper feeding can regulate, IV infusion of the supplements, blood transfusion in severe cases, iron supplements and supplement tonics. So this is actually a HemoBest Plus, that is dietary supplement. Dietary supplement based on folic acid, iron sulfate and vitamins. So if at all you are feeding the animal with this hematinic syrup, it will sometimes prevent anemia. So we can move to the blood pictures of anemia. So this is actually normal RBC production, normal hemoglobin. So this is anemic blood. You can see RBCs are very few and the concentration of hemoglobin inside the RBC is also less. So you can see the blood pictures. Thank you.